We want to assume that there is a reason for everything. An event is inanimate. It is what it is. So let's say you're networking and you have a networking conversation that doesn't go well. So what? Our observing eye, which is our objective eye, can say, all right, I get it. It was just a bad meeting. Moving on. Our perceiving eye won't let us stop there. It'll say, oh no, that person hates me now. Oh no, they're never going to help me. Oh no, everyone's talking about me behind my back. Oh no, all of these thoughts, right? We have to listen to that voice and then put it in its place. Negative emotions should not be ignored, but they should be listened to in an appropriate manner. If we ignore them, if we bottle them up, if we push them to the side, if we don't think about things, they tend to just sour in the wings. We have to see with both eyes, right? We have to say, I understand that I'm feeling this way after a bad interview or a bad networking thing or lack of response from an email or someone not getting back to us or whatever it might be. But we have to realize that it's trying to tell us something. Not to run away, that's trying to ignore the feeling and try and get rid of it. Own the feeling and say, okay, now that I know I'm feeling, let's say, embarrassed about that networking meeting, what is that embarrassment trying to tell me? That embarrassment is trying to tell me that I should prepare more for the next conversation. Okay, that's directional. That's something we can control. That is something that we own. So instead of saying, how could this have happened? This is going to ruin me. That person's a jerk. We need to say, what is the reality of this situation? So I'll just put myself in the hot seat, right? I'm a career coach. I'm trying to build a career coaching business. Right now it's me and some contractors, but I'm hoping I'm going to grow it into a large organization of some sort, maybe 10 to 20 people max, maybe 10 people max. I want it to be a small but mighty organization. And as I'm working in that direction, I'm experimenting every single day and failing every single day. It's not even about me at the end of the day. None of it is. It's not about career therapy. It's not about Martin McGovern. It's not about any of these things that I create. First of all, none of these things are me. They're just things I've created. The job search, in your case, is not even about you. It's about the services you provide to a company and how they can utilize those services to make more money as a business. So as you're thinking about this in your world, in your work, what are you feeling like is getting in the way of your objective view of things? What perceptions are you holding on to that are not serving you in your job search? And how can we overcome them?